let's go check the Rotten Tomatoes reviews for Harry Potter. Oh, Armin White. God. The dullest movie franchise ever. Wow. Troll! Troll in the dungeon! This is the last review for the Harry Potter extravaganza. Well, actually, the last review will be part two, but I've already reviewed part one, actually only a couple months ago, and I know I'd already reviewed Half-Blood Prince previously, but, you know, I thought I'd just do a quick recap. Now, I know a lot of people don't like part one. I know a lot of people say it's slow, and a lot of people say not a lot happens, and they were expecting a lot more action, but I personally love part one. I think there's sufficient action, but the point of the movie is to be exposition. It is supposed to lead up to this epic finale, and you can't have that if you don't supply the story. Even though the story is mainly feeding off the story from Half-Blood Prince, you still gotta have some story build up there, and that is what part one was designed to do. That's why they split it into movies, so you could have one and the other, and I still really love part one for what it is. I mean, I'd agree that the movie does get a little slow at times, but even in the book, I felt that the middle half was very slow. Not that it doesn't pick up, and not that I don't like that part, I just do think it does drag a little bit, but actually in the movie, I feel like I didn't feel the length as much as I did in the book. Yes, reading and watching is different, but I feel like they actually did a good job of speeding up and not cutting a lot out. The only thing I really said that they did cut out that was I had a problem with was the Albus Dumbledore backstory, The Life and Lies. I know they're probably going to bring some of that back for part two. You have to for Aberforth and such. But I really would have wished them to start that earlier. But nonetheless, I still really love part one. Part one is the on-the-run movie, to part two is the confrontation movie, and I love that. It is this stealth movie, it has this hiding. I love the atmosphere of this movie. The little additions that made, like them walking through these barren wastelands with Death Eaters flying overhead, and these the drones of the radio. It was just this amazing atmospherical conversion of ominous foreboding. The beginning of Deathly Hallows, even in the book, is about kind of turning everything on its head, turning everything you know about this wizarding world and changing it, making you feel unsafe, making you feel scared for these characters by starting it off by killing off characters, injuring characters, characters that you never thought go. The feeling of security, like, oh, you've overcome this plan, and then you fly into the sky, and there's 1,000 Death Eaters waiting for you. The action scenes in this movie are absolutely stunning as well. Yes, there's not a lot of them, but that's the point, you know? The part two is this huge orgasm of action, and this movie is the prelude. I mean, if you can't understand what exposition is, you shouldn't be watching Harry Potter in the first place, because 90% of the series is narrative. Deathly Hallows Part 1 is easily one of my favorite Harry Potter movies, and for a lot of reasons. I think the acting is amazing, I think the script is very well written, perfectly adapted from the book. Yes, I'm always gonna have my little grievances, but you know, it's someone else's interpretation, and I have to respect that. And considering it's one of my favorites, when Part 2 comes out, if I like Part 2 that much, I'm just gonna hold them as one movie. I'm not gonna say Part 1's my favorite, Part 2's my favorite. I'm gonna say Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, and very well may be my favorite of the Harry Potter series, and I hope so. Crucial! And I've said this before, I love the cinematography in the series, and this is no exception. I think it's actually some of the best, especially in that opening montage, which perfectly sets the tone for a movie. I love that opening montage, and especially Emily Watson gives the star performance of this movie without a doubt. I know I'm talking more about the movie here than I am about the book, which is different than my other reviews for the extravaganza, but I'm waiting for part two to come out, and I will do... I'm still even gonna make Harry Potter videos for the next week, so... I know this is really short, and I'm sorry about that, because I've already reviewed it, so go check out that review if you really want a full recap of what I think of the movie, even though that review sucked. But, I will see you guys tonight. I know! Clusterfuck.